your knees until you feel it within your heart to repent. Until your wickedness is cleansed from your soul. When all trace of sin is removed, you will stay here until then. Until you find repentance. Until the evil is driven from you.
Father, please don't leave me in here again.
Until you repent!
Father! You're out there. Help me. Grace, I know you're out there. Help me. Grace, help me. Myra, I can't. I can't, you know, Father. Grace, I didn't do anything. I went for a ride with Joel after the church social. A harmless ride, Grace. I didn't do anything. I know you're out there. Help me.
I'm afraid, Myra. I'm afraid.
Grace!
I'm afraid.
Grace!
Seen mountains before, Charlie. Not mountains like those. People miss so much living in one place all their years.
Well, it ain't all as pretty as it looks from here, Miss Marshall. Them high mountain passes can get awfully bad in the winter. And beyond those mountains on the other side are some of the hottest deserts in the whole creation, too.
Good and evil. They always seem to lie close together, don't they, Charlie?
That's what they say. How this is going to be your last supper on the train, I kind of wanted to make it a surprise.
I'm sure it will be. Sounds like the O'Malleys are celebrating again.
Oh, it'll probably be the last chance they have to for a while. We'll be climbing into the mountains tomorrow.
I'm going to be sorry to leave the train. You've all been very kind in the past several weeks. And I'll miss your cooking, Charlie.
It's been a pleasure. Cooking for you, Miss Marshall.
I hear there's a stream nearby.
Yes, there is. Just in back of the O'Malley wagons.
Be a half hour before supper's ready.
Thank you, Charlie.
I reckon I'll shave.
Smells pretty good, huh?
Shaving again, eh, Duke?
Yep. Well, a man doesn't have to look like Charlie just because he rides with him.
Huh. Doesn't seem to much danger of that. Your case. Ever since Grace Marshall joined this train, that beard of yours hasn't had a chance to see daylight.
Miss Marshall's gone for a walk.
I think I'll shave before supper.
I figured you would.
Cleanest shaven bunch of hands I've ever had.
I saw you from under the wagon. I mistook you for somebody else. Beg pardon.
Supper's ready, Mr. Chris.
Fine, Charlie. Only takes one of you to fetch her, you know.
I'll flip you. Heads, you go.
Heads, I go.
Your idea.
Softly.
Habit, I reckon. Man stays alive a lot longer on a trail if he doesn't advertise it. Supper's ready. One of the O'Malleys told me you were down here.
A wagon train's a world all its own, isn't it?
A small world.
Not as small or as narrow as mine was. Coop. Kiss me, Coop. Kiss me.
Mm-hmm.
It's wrong. It's sinful. I'm sorry.
Grace!
More coffee, anyone?
Thank you, Barney.
I think I'll go to bed early, and I do have some packing to do. It was a wonderful dinner, Charlie.
Thank you.
I'll always remember it.
Thank you.
We'll be at the Fortune City cutoff about mid-morning, Grace. Coop will drive you. You know, that's a pretty tough mining town. If you didn't have a sister there, I wouldn't let you go.
Thank you for all you've done for me, Mr. Hale. And I do appreciate your concern, but I'm sure I'll be all right. Good night.
Night.
Night, Miss Marshall.
Night. Real beautiful girl, ain't she? Wonder why she never married.
She's a strange girl. I wonder what her sister's doing in Fortune City. She didn't tell me. Only that she was married to an army man. Why? Because I know the town. If I had a wife, I wouldn't take her there.
Burns changed. Become insanely jealous. He was kicked out of the army 3 months after we were married. He's dragged me from one frontier town to another. I can't begin to tell you what I've been through, the degradation, the humiliation. I'm afraid, Grace. Afraid it'll kill me someday. I'm at the end of my rope. I'm sick. I need money. I need help. Please, Grace. Please.
You to feel obligated.
Obligated? Because of what?
Because of what happened last night.
I kissed a pretty girl, that's all. There's nothing wrong with that, is it?
It was for me. I asked you to. I've never kissed a man before.
Mr. Hale said your sister married an army man. As far as I know, there's not an army post within 40 miles of Fortune City.
Byrne left the army 3 years ago. Sister stranded there with him.
I don't care what you think or how you feel. You can't leave me. I'm sick. I've got to have some money.
I'm sorry, Myra.
I am sick, Burr. Do you hear? I'm sick.
I'll try and get Doc Barnes.
I don't want that old quack pawing me. Burr, I've got to have money to eat.
Pull yourself together and get dressed. I'll come back and take you out to dinner.
Don't leave me. I've got to have some money, Burn! Burn! I got to have money!
No money, Myra.
Get it!
don't get it from you, I'll get it from someone, but I'll get it. Burn, do you hear me? Burn!
I'll get you settled at the hotel, and then we'll find your sister.
Wait.
Oh.
That's Vern, my sister's husband.
Lock him up, Marshal.
I tell you, I was robbed!
Trouble from these two, Marshal. Take them over to Doc Barnes, get them patched up, and get them both out of town. You understand me, Vern?
Show them where the doc's office is.
Mr. Rossman?
Grace? Grace Marshall.
Where's Myra? Where is she, Vern?
Grace, Myra isn't expecting any company. Let me tell her you're here.
Shall I ask someone else?
She's in our room. It's over the saddle shop on Mountain Avenue.
Will you take me there?
Glad to see me?
Of course. I just wasn't expecting you, that's all.
Well, I wrote.
Make yourself at home, such as it is. How's our dear old father,
Well, what's the matter? Did I say something wrong?
Didn't you get my letter?
With $50? How hard did you have to twist his arm?
Myra, father's dead.
I guess I didn't read that far. Well, here's to dear old Daddy, wherever he may be. Oh, I forgot. You don't drink. No vices. Still a good little girl, huh, Grace?
Grace! Grace, help me. I'm sick.
I've got a doctor. There must be one in town.
No! He's a friend of Vern's. He's an old quack. He won't come.
But you can't stay here like this if you're sick.
Grace. Grace, I've got to have some money. Father must have left something, just something to help me straighten myself out.
There isn't much left after the funeral.
That'll be enough. Grace, why don't you leave me alone for a while, huh? I know how I must look. I'll just clean up and put on a dress.
I'll get a room in the hotel and wait for you there.
I'll look for Moshe.
Yes, soon as I can.
Maybe you might like to get something to eat.
Thank you, but I'm not hungry.
What's wrong, Grace? Is it your sister?
She's not well. Coop, I know you're leaving in the morning. I want to leave with you, my sister, too.
What about her husband?
Vern? Saw him this afternoon, what kind of a man he is. You've got to help me get her away from him before it's too late.
Grace, did you give Myra some money?
I don't believe that concerns you.
Did you?
You're upsetting the lady, mister.
Stay out of what you don't know, Grace.
Listen to me.
You stay out of it, too, mister.
Please, Coop, no trouble.
Leave Myra alone, Grace. I'll take care of her.
The way you have been, Vern?
Yes.
I'm going to find Myra. She should have been here by now.
I'll go with you.
For a girl.
This would be much prettier filled with silver.
Here's to the prettiest girl in the world.
A toast to...
I'm going home, Myra.
Not yet, Vern. The fun's just starting.
Just a minute, Marshall.
Get out of here.
You gonna put me out, Marshal?
Anna Riley, wait a minute. Hold it. Hold it. Give me the drink. Give me the drink. Give me the drink. This is his wife. That's his wife.
A man should stay home with his wife.
Come on, you stay home with your wife, and then you can talk.
Come on home.
Still the protective husband, huh, Vern? Be such a spoiled sport. Stick around. You might even have some fun.
Let's go home.
No. I can't go home. I belong out here where there's laughter and voices and noise. Try and strangle me, Vern. Don't try and bottle me up. I'm not made that way.
Your sister's out looking for you.
Oh, dear saintly frightened Grace. You like her. You would.
You coming?
No.
You want me to drag you?
You? You wouldn't dare.
What's the matter with you, Myra? Don't you know what's happening to you, what you've become? You're a tramp.
Are you gonna drag me out of here?
This is the last time I come looking for you. Grace's sister. She wasn't home. I could have told you that. Then where is she? Why should I tell you?
Because Grace is worried about her and wants to know where she is.
What's Grace Marshall to you?
Just a friend who asked me for some help, that's all. My name's Cooper Smith. I'm with the Hale wagon train. Grace came out here with us.
Where is Grace now?
I took her back to the hotel. She doesn't belong in a town like this.
You do her a favor, Smith. Take her back to the wagon train with you.
Not without her sister. All right, I'll find her myself.
Just a minute, Smith. You'll find Myra at Brenner's Silver Palace. Maybe she'll go back with you. I hope she does.
Sisters. Come on, let's go.
Take your hands off her.
Like I said, mister, I'm a friend of her sister's. She's waiting for us. Come on, let's go.
I don't think you heard me. This is a private party.
Colin, put that thing away.
Take it easy.
Well, it's your party. Go ahead, take her. But don't come back. Either of you. May I?
Leave it there. Let's go.
I feel so good.
Grace is waiting for you at the hotel. I promised I'd bring you there.
Not now. Take me home, huh?
All right, I'll take you home. Come on.
Grace's friend, I didn't think. That dear Grace. Well, don't leave me. Stay here with me.
I'll get your husband.
No. No, stay with me. I don't feel so well.
See if I can get you a doctor.
No! Get on here. Come here. Why? Where was Myra when you found her? I want to know, Coop.
Over at Brenner's. It's a gambling hall down the street.
Was Vern with her?
No. But he told me where to find her. Grace. How long has it been since you last saw your sister?
5 years. Not since the day she eloped with Vern. I know. It's not the sort of place you'd expect to find a minister's daughter, is it?
I never figured it made much difference.
But it does to me. Myra and I were raised differently. Not like that. Not like... Father was strict with us. Myra was always a little wild.
But she wasn't bad. Whatever she's become, it's Vern's fault.
Don't be so shocked, Grace. Vern's gonna make an honest woman out of me.
But it's wrong of Vern to do this. What will I tell Father?
You can tell him whatever you like. But he's never gonna punish me again. Never gonna lock me in that attic room and point his finger at me, accusing me. Calling me evil. Calling me dirty. Vern's taking me away. I'm going to be free. Free of Father. Free of his lectures on sin. Free of all of it.
Myra, you know it isn't right what you're doing. Eloping like a...
Like a woman? That's what I am, Grace. Not a plaster saint. Not a symbol of goodness out of Father's good book.
But Vern should speak with Father. It isn't right.
Vern loves me. He wants to take me away tonight, and I'm going.
Myra?
You stay, Grace. You take care of Father. But you'll never be good enough for him. Just like Mother was never good enough. You stay here and wither away. Just like Mother did. But not me. Vern's taking me away. He's going to make me a lady. The wife of an officer of the United States Army. Myra! Goodbye, Grace.
She thought she was going to be happy, be free. She believed what Vern told her. Instead, Vern dragged her into the mud, through a dozen horrible towns like this one. Humiliated her, degraded her. I thought I could help by coming here, by just being with her. I can't. Not alone. I need your help to take her away from him.
Tonight?
Yes. Please.
All right, Grace, I'll get the wagon ready. I don't think it'll do any good.
Why not?
I don't think she'll go with you.
Because of Vern?
No. Because of you.
His name's Smith. Cooper Smith. Works for a wagon train passing through south of town.
Vern's friend?
Maybe. He rode into town with Myra's sister. They checked in at the hotel.
Get Reno up here right away. I've got a job for him.
Thank you.
Town for a girl like you to be out alone.
Too rough for me, Vern. But not for Myra. Not for your wife.
Right now, I'm concerned about you.
That's very kind of you.
Don't fight me, Grace. Not you.
Just don't try to stop us, Vern.
Stop you?
I'm taking Myra with me tonight. We're going to California.
She won't go with you.
I don't believe that.
Leave her alone, Grace. What's happened to Myra can't be changed now.
Smith?
I was thinking on it.
You ain't moving anywhere until you pay us $50.
What for?
Haven't you heard? City taxes. We're the tax collectors.
Did Brenner send you?
No one sends us, Smith. Just a job.
Well, I don't want to argue with you. It's a city ordinance. I reckon I better pay.
Let's quit fooling, Reno.
Now we'll figure the tax paid. And you tell Brenner I'll leave when I'm ready. Now move!
Boss, don't want to see nobody.
Oh, yes.
Oh, wait.
Let me get in to see him. Wait, Thomas.
Let her in, Nick. I didn't want to see you in here again.
I need money.
You're not worth a silver dollar.
You gave them to me, remember?
You came cheap, Myra.
You didn't think so once.
You taking a good look at yourself in the mirror lately? I'm busy.
Colin. Please. For old time's sake. $30?
What for? So you can blow it in Ling's back room?
You took me there the first time.
Come on, Myra. You were hooked on the stuff before you came here.
Colin, please.
Get out.
I'll tell Vern, Colin. I'll tell Vern about us.
Go ahead, tell Vern.
But I don't like to be threatened, Myra. Not by you. Not from anybody.
This, Myra.
Colin Brin. Didn't want to tell you before about Colin and me. Didn't want to hurt you. Don't know why I did it. It's other times, it's other places. Something inside me driving me to hurt you. Hurt everybody. End the line for us, huh, Vern? All gone, what we had. We did have some good times, didn't we, Vern? Didn't we?
I was in love with you.
Vern. Just couldn't be a good wife.
Goodbye, Myra.
Vern?
Your sister is coming with Doc Barnes. She'll stay with you.
I don't want my sister here, Vern. Don't you understand?
She wants to take you back with her. I guess it's best for us both if you go with her.
I'm never going back to that house, Vern. I'm never going back to that house.
Thank you.
wasn't expecting you, Vern. Let me buy you a drink.
No, thanks. I took Myra home. My wife, Brenna. Why?
She came to my office and threatened me. She's come a lot of times, Vern.
She told me. Your gun, Brenna. Taking you in.
Me? You've come to arrest me? If you pick up that badge, Vern, I'll put a hole right through your head. Give him the badge, Smith. But it won't make him a man. It won't help you either. Not in this town.
Your town, Brenner?
My town. If you don't have him out of it by morning, I'm going to kill you.
We'll see. Got something. Takes a good man to wear it in a town like this.
Brenna's man.
You don't have to be anybody's man.
Once, maybe a long time ago, I take Grace out of here, Coop. tonight. She won't go, Vern. Not without her sister. Why did you stay with Myra for 5 years? I know what your wife is like. I took her out of Brenner's. Grace still thinks you're the cause of Myra being the way she is.
And you don't?
Grace told me a little bit about her father. About the way she and Myra were raised. Grace is... yeah, she's still afraid of being a woman.
And Myra?
I think she went the other way. It was the only way she could get back at her father.
I loved her, Coop. Sometimes she was all any man could want. We were married in a small chapel. Funny how it sticks in your mind, the way the minister said it. In sickness and in health, until death do us part. If I'd gone to her father and talked to him instead of just running off like that, things might have turned out differently. So maybe in a way I am responsible. But I was in love. Crazy, wild in love. With a beautiful, exciting girl. That's the way it started. I loved her. As much as any man could love a woman. Maybe I don't love her now. I don't know anymore. But she's still my wife, and I can't just leave her here. I can't run away and forget her.
You don't have to run. See you in the morning.
Better.
I'm sorry that things were
Not better. How's your father?
He's dead.
I'm sorry. Sorry for everything.
It's too late for that.
You came here to kill me. Go ahead.
I should kill you. I should.
But I can't.
Grace, I never harmed Myra.
Harmed her? You don't know what you've done to her, what you've made of her. Why, Vern? Because you were tired of her?
You're talking like a schoolgirl.
And how should I talk? Like the girls in the gambling halls? I know how you've treated my sister. You've dragged her through a dozen horrible, miserable towns like this. You've humiliated her, you've degraded her, and now she's sick and she's...
Is that what Myra told you?
It's what she wrote. And it's what I've seen.
Yes, you've seen a sick girl, Grace. But it isn't anything that you or I or even a doctor can cure.
I'll take care of her. Just leave her alone and let her come away with me.
I won't try and stop you. But first, I want you to listen to me. Listen to the truth.
Just leave her alone!
You came here to kill me. Now, listen to me. The night that I took Myra away from you and your father, running away, that wasn't my idea. No matter what you think, I had a proper upbringing, too. I knew I was eloping with a minister's daughter.
I hope Father is watching.
I think I should talk it out with your father.
Oh, Vern, it wouldn't do any good. It'd only make a scene, start preaching about sin and damnation.
Say anything, Myra. Not now.
I'm the one who should be upset, not you. If you just don't believe that what he said is true, then it doesn't matter. I don't mind. Vern? You do believe me, don't you, Vern? Vern?
Let go of me, Myra.
Vern, he didn't mean anything.
I saw him and I heard him. He insulted you.
What are you going to do?
I'm going to give the man a chance to take it back. Then...
Vern, he isn't worth it. Now, we've got a whole lifetime ahead of us. What do we care what anybody says? What anybody thinks?
Myra, you're my wife. I'll ask you once again. What he said That isn't true, is it?
Vern, you can't believe that I...
Then he insulted you. And I'll have to kill him. Kicked out of the army. We went from town to town, always running away. It was always the same story. Drunken brawls or worse. And we came out west the end of the line. It's been a long, wild 5 years, Grace. Because she wanted it that way. Maybe I wanted to believe her, but all the lies and the drinking and strange men crowding into our life.
No. It's a lie. It's all a lie.
Then ask her.
Sleep. I went out. I went to kill Vern.
Kill Vern? Why? What did he ever do to you?
It was what I thought he did to you. The letter you wrote to me. It was all a lie, wasn't it, Myra? Wasn't it?
Would you and Father have preferred the truth? I needed money. Vern wouldn't give it to me.
So you lied to get it.
Lie? I do more than that. I beg. I cheat. Yes, I'd even steal. Don't you know? Didn't Vern tell you? I've been taking dope, dear sister. Opium for almost a year. Now, will you get out of here?
Myra, please!
I don't want your help now! You're too late! All those years when Father locked me in the attic, that's when I needed your help. But you were afraid. You're always afraid!
Myra, I wanted to help. I want to help now. Maybe if you prayed.
Prayed? I don't know what that means. I grew up in my father's house, in the shadow of his church, and I don't know what that means. God to me is my father standing in that attic doorway, pointing his finger at me, accusing me, condemning me. That's what God is. I don't know how to pray,
Myra.
Oh, no. I don't want your pity. And I don't want your help. Now, will you get out of here?
Get some rest, Grace. I'll take care of Myra. I'm closing shop. Thank you. You should have taken her out of here. She didn't want to go. Not just yet, anyway. You could have stayed out of this, Coop. It's not your fight. It's as much mine as it is yours, the way I figure it. Four? Why not? I figure it's about even.
I didn't figure you'd be dumb enough to still be here, Vern.
Quit running.
I'm kind of glad you stayed too, Smith. I owe you something.
Get him inside.
I'm sorry for what we've done to you, Vern.
Going home?
I'm going west to California. I think I'm ready for it.
Good luck, Grace. I'll be seeing you, Vern. So long. Goodbye, Coop.